everybody. Mrs. Dabbs, once again, with your second challenge. Well done, those of you that have mastered tying your shoelaces already. I've been so impressed with the videos that have been sent through. So very, very well done. I know you've practiced hard and concentrated hard to get that right. So your second challenge is, as I mentioned a couple of weeks ago, is to learn to do a tie. Now, this will take a little bit of practice. I needed to ask my assistant, contacted Mr. Bean. He sent his bear through. He said he doesn't mind if he will take part in this new challenge. So he's my assistant, okay? And I thought for some of you football fans out there, especially those in our class that particularly like Southend, I would borrow Mr. Dabbs's tie. Let's hope he doesn't need that for work later. So here we go. Okay, so the first part of the challenge is to take the tie and make sure that the thinner bit, just here at the back, is slightly shorter than the wider end. Okay, so make sure your tie is kind of in that position. It doesn't matter, you don't have to measure it out or anything. You'll soon get used to how you prefer to wear it. All right, so that's step one. Once you've done that, you need to place the tie, obviously around your neck or around, in this case, Mr. Bean's bear. So we're just putting that round his neck, okay? The wider piece of the tie, just here, which has got the Southend logo on, that will go just across, which we'll put it, I think we'll do it very slowly, we'll just put it into a cross just there. Okay, so your first part, as we've just said, is very slowly so you have time to copy, is to make sure that the thinner part of the tie is shorter, okay, and it needs to be behind the wider part, okay, and then we put that around the bear's neck in this case, okay, and put the wider piece over the thinner part of the tie, so you have just a cross, okay, so try that a couple of times. Okay, once you've got that in that position, then we'll move on to the second part. Okay, it's a little bit tricky because the bear's quite mobile. So what we're now going to do is move the wide part of the tie, so the piece that's over the top, just underneath. Okay, underneath the other part. All right, shall I do that again? I hope you can see clearly. It's a little bit tricky to balance him. He's sitting on the bread bin at the moment. So here we go, the wider part of the tie, we've crossed it over and we're just going to put it underneath. All right, now the next part is to place that wider part over the tie again, so just over there, just over the front of the tie. Okay, I'll do that one more time. So you've placed it underneath already and we just put it over the top. Okay, so just over the top of the other piece. We're almost there actually, doing very well. So what we're going to do now is take this top part of the tie, the wider part remember, we're going to tuck it underneath so that it comes up here through this hole. Okay, so I'll do that slowly. There we are, it's come up through the top. All right, I'll give you a few minutes to have a practice of that. I'll take it back down, show you one more time. So that wider part, as we say, goes up through this hole and it needs to come through the top. Okay, and then you'll be ready for the last piece. All right, this tie needs to go through here. Okay, so behind this little knot that you've created, we tuck it in here. I need two hands really, and I'm trying to hold the bear. bear with me. Okay, so we've pushed it through here and we're now just going to pull it. I'll try and do that with two hands so that you can see. Pull it through. There we go, make it tighter. That is a little bit too wide, but I think you probably understand the process. Okay, so I've pulled that through. and there he is, complete with his south end tie. Okay, good luck with that, and hope to see you again soon. Bye for now. And finally, what you might find helpful is this 6-part visual diagram, just to take you through the steps that we've practiced together. So good luck with all of that. Send your videos through to your form tutors so we can see how you're getting on, and stay well and safe, and we hope to see you very soon. Take care. Bye for now.